Hello everyone. In this module, I am going to demonstrate how you can create contactless component using data table and place it on account record page. So I'm jumping into developer console. So first I will be creating a contact controller that will be written in Apex. So that controller will be returning all the related contacts for particular account. Then I will be implementing Lightning Aura component. So clicking on File, New, Apex class, naming it as Contact Controller. So in this class, I need to write the code and I am going to implement a method public static list of contact. Method name is getContacts, and it will be receiving one parameter of type record ID. Right now, I'm going to call this method in my Lightning Aura component. So I need to use @ Aura enabled annotation. Then I'm using return statement. So in this return statement, I'm directly using SOQL. So SOQL always returns a list. So that list will be returned with these fields. So this SOQL will query ID, first name, last name, email, and phone number from contact where account ID is equals to this record ID. So all those records, all those contact records will be queried where account ID is equals to this record ID. So this way I created this contact controller, which is written in Apex. So this Apex controller now I need to use in Lightning Aura component. So it's time to create Lightning component. So clicking here and naming it as contact list. Now we need to place this Lightning component on record page. So I'm enabling this checkbox and clicking on submit. So in this example, you will also understand like how we can fetch record ID of the record where this component is placed. So we need to create one attribute named as record ID for that. So I enabled that checkbox. So here you can see, FlexiPage available for record home is available, and force colon has record ID is also available, right? So this is the interface which provides you record ID automatically in this Lightning component. Now here I'm creating attributes. So Aura attribute name equals to record ID, type equals to ID. So this is the first attribute that I created. So name will be always this, like a record will be in small and I should be in capital and the D should be in small. So this record ID attribute will be having the record ID of the record where this Lightning component is placed automatically because of this force colon has record ID. Now I'm going to create one more attribute. Name equals to account and type is also equals to account. Then one more attribute, name equals to contacts, type equals to contact. And one more, name equals to columns and type equals to list. This columns attribute I will be using while implementing data table. So we have four attributes. Record ID will be storing record ID, account will be storing account related information, contacts will be storing all contact related information, and columns, this is a list that will be we will be using to display list of contacts in data table. Then Aura handler, name equals to init, value equals to this, and action equals to c dot my action. So this I already explained and demonstrated in previous modules. So this executes automatically because its name is init. So whenever your component loads, so this handler will be executed and this my action function will be called automatically. Now I'm using foods colon record data. So it is a tag, or you can say like Lightning data service. So through this, we need to pass the ID of particular record, and that record related information will be stored automatically. So I am creating Aura ID as account record. Then we need to pass record ID. So that is available in the record ID attribute. So we can use it like this. So we need to create expression. So expression, we already saw in the previous module how we can create expressions in Aura component. Then target fields equals to v.account. So basis on this record ID, we are going to fetch account related information, because this record ID will be having only account record ID, because we are going to place this on account record page, and the that records information will be available in this account. And then layout type equals to full. So this way, this foods colon record data tag is implemented completely. Now it's time to implement another one. So it is Lightning card icon name equals to standard contact. Title equals to contact list for plus v dot account dot name, and I am not closing it here. Yep. So it is closed here. So I'm not using slash here, because inside this Lightning card, I am going to use Lightning data table tag, right? So what we did here, so here we have a title, which is going to display like contact list for, this is a plain text, and account name will be fetched from this expression, right? So v.account.name. So here we fetched account related information in this attribute. And through dot, we are fetching particular field, that is name. Now, inside this Lightning card, so this is Lightning card tag. So here, this is the beginning of this, and this is the ending. Now here I'm writing Lightning data table data equals to, so data will be provided through v.context. Right, so v.context, so context attribute is available here. So we are fetching that. Then columns equals to v.columns. Then next we have key field, that will be ID. Right, so key field means like what will be the key for this Lightning data table if you select particular row from that data table. So this key field is basically for that. And then we have hide checkbox column equals to false. and closing this data table. So Lightning data table is having these four attributes. One is data. Data will be available here, then v.columns. So columns, like we need to map this context with this column so that we will do in the JavaScript controller. So after mapping, columns will be created, and whatever data is available in this context, they will be displayed in particular column. Then key field is ID and hide checkbox column. So in data table, checkboxes will be available. So in this example, like basic data table will be displayed. Later on in another module, I will show you some more features related to data table. Right. So I have saved this code. Now it's time to create JavaScript controller. So in JavaScript controller, we need to implement this my action, because it will be executed automatically whenever this component will be loaded. And at the time of component load, we need to do some operations. So I am clicking on this controller. So here you can see this controller is open. So here my action is available and function name is already my action. So now I need to write component.set v.column. So we need to set its mapping. So here I'm writing label colon first name, field name colon first name, and type colon text. Right, so this is basically JSON format. So label of this column will be first name, field name will be first name, and type will be text. So when we are using this v.column attribute here with this data like context, so from context, first name field will be mapped automatically with the first name column, and the values will be placed. So this way we need to implement it. Now I'm copying this, pasting it. And it will be last name. Field name will be last name. And here label will be phone. Field name will be phone. And type will be phone. And here I am putting semicolon. So this thing is completed. Now what we need to do, so after this column mapping, we need to call this context controller method, that is get context, right? So before we write the code, we need to jump here, and here we need to write controller equals to context controller, right? So this I explained in the previous module. Like if you want to access Apex class method, so you need to mention this statement like controller and name of the Apex controller. Now here you can write the code so that you can call that particular method, which is defined in context controller method. Sorry, context controller Apex class. So here you need to create one variable named as action. Then component.get c dot get context. So name of context controller method is get context. So we need to use it here. Now here in this method, you can see we need to pass one attribute or one value, that is record ID. So we need to set the parameters. So action dot set params. So in this module, you will also learn how we can pass parameters from this Aura component to Apex controller. So record ID colon component dot get v dot record id. So basically this record id is the parameter that is mentioned here, which will be receiving the value, and which value. So we need to get the attribute that we created in the component. So here it is, record ID. And this record ID will be having automatically a count record ID wherever this component is placed. Now we need to close this. Here you don't need to put any semicolon. You just need to close this. After this, you can write action.setCallback. This comma function data. Inside this, you can write component.set v.contexts data.get return value. So whatever returned value will be available that you need to set in this context attribute. So with this, you can do that. Now you need to write $a.NQAction and you need to pass action. So this way your Aura components controller is also implemented. So we created three things. First, we created this Apex controller. Then we created view of Aura component. Then we created JavaScript controller for the Aura component. Now it's time to place this component on the record page. So I am moving to account and opening particular account record. So on this account here, you can see contexts are not available. So let me open any account where contexts are associated. So here on this account, two contexts are available. So what I am going to do, I am going to create one more tab here on this record page. And in that tab, I will be placing that Lightning Aura component. So I'm going to edit this page. So Lightning record page will be open in the Lightning app builder. And if you scroll down, so here you will find your component. So here it is, like contact list. Now what we need to do, we need to create one tab. And then inside that tab, I will be placing this. So here I am adding one more tab. Naming it as contact list. So it is created and now I am dragging and dropping it here. Right? So clicking on save, moving back. So here you can see contact list for United Oil and Gas Singapore. So this account name is displayed successfully, but it is not showing data table. So we need to check our code. Okay, so there's a mistake. Like here you can see attribute name is columns. And I used only column. So that's why they are not mapping. So what you can do always, you can copy this and you can use it like pasting its name. So in that case, it will work fine. So I saved it and I'm doing a refresh. So this time you can see data table is available. Here we have checkboxes for selection. Right. If you want to do some more custom work, like after selection of this, so you can do with the Lightning data table. And first name, last name, phone for the contexts which are associated with the with account are displayed here. Right. And if I move to any account where contexts are not available, so in that case, this list will be showing the headers only. And the detailed values won't be available because on this account, no contact is available. So this way, I hope you understood how we can create a contact list using Lightning data table and how we can place that on record page. Thank you.